Okay, hello everybody. I'm here with my good friend Arturo Franco, who's a non-resident fellow at the Atlantic Council working on Mexico. He's also a member of the Alumni Board of Directors of the Kennedy School, and we're actually meeting here at the Kennedy School in Cambridge for a board meeting. And I thought that I would take 5 of his minutes just to talk about Trump and Mexico and the elections in Mexico. So I'm just going to ask you, I mean, the first question is, what has the impact of Trump been on Mexico, and what do you think the impact is going to be on NAFTA? So what is your assessment of this first year of the Trump presidency?
Well, I think many people minimized the impact that Trump could have when the election process was going on. But we must never forget that Trump mentioned Mexico in his first speech when he announced he was running for president.
That's right.
He mentioned Mexico in 5 out of 6 debates in the Republican primaries, and he made a big subject of his campaign the idea of building a wall. Mm-hmm. So once you put all of that together, the impact that we were expecting was much bigger than what we've had in the first year. Not, I think, because he doesn't want to do these things, but because he hasn't been allowed.
What about the NAFTA question? I mean, what do you think the future of NAFTA is?
So I think it's not looking good. As you know, we're in the 5th round of negotiations. The attitude of the United States, and particularly of President Trump, has been more and more negative. To the point where people are expecting him or the administration to pull unilaterally out of the agreement before the year ends.
So you think that's a possibility?
I think that is a very strong possibility. And we are also running out of time, because if you think about it, if we don't get to a new agreement this year,
yep.
Next year there is already a presidential election in Mexico, which means we're going to change our Congress and our Senate.
Yeah.
The next year there's an election in the U.S., a Senate race, and then the next year there's already like the primaries of the U.S. election. So
right.
So the political timing is not great. We would basically be in an impasse for a while.
So let me ask you a final question, but a very important one. How does the electoral cycle in Mexico next year look? What do you think are going to be the key dynamics that are going to play out next year in Mexico?
Yeah, well, it's looking.
Are we going to have a López Obrador government?
I believe that it is the most likely scenario today. Okay. Of course, there's all kinds of wishful thinking from many sides. People that think that the independents are going to have a big impact and you know, take votes away from AMLO. People that think that this coalition, strange coalition between the right, center-right and center-left parties could have a chance. And people who think that the PRI machinery, which they used in the state of Mexico and Coahuila in the last election, is still there and strong and could pull it off. But every poll puts Andrés Manuel ahead by a good margin right now. I think it's his election to lose.
Okay, well, that's exciting. Well, we'll leave it at that. Thanks a lot for finding the time to do this. And goodbye to all of you from the Kennedy School and its new wing, which they just opened. Bye-bye.
Thank you.